Everybody, how are you doing? All right, we're starting. It's Jeff Gellman in Sally Canine Training and Linda. We're in our RV and we're going to start our show. We, if you're brand new to the show, just give us a couple minutes. We'd like to do a little bit of an intro. Say hello to all of our regulars. People can have a lot of questions, but don't worry. We will answer your dog training questions today. Don't worry about that at all. Okay. Okay, hold on. Let's get this all situated here, all right?
Harry.
Can you get it more? What if I sit like this? There. Okay. I thought it worked on the other one there. There we go. Better. Okay. All right. Hey, everybody. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training and Linda, and we're here for the What Would Jeff Do radio show every Monday and Wednesday from 9 p.m. Standard Time. What I do is I answer all your dog training questions. Hey, Terry in Utah, how are you? So what we're doing now is, if you're not familiar with who I am, you can go to my website at Solid Canine Training, Solid Canine Training, solidcaninetraining.com.
Hi, Don.
Check out who we are, what we do. I've got a dog training facility in Providence, Rhode Island. You start writing some of those down. Dog training facility in Providence, Rhode Island. And what we're doing now is we're on the road traveling 18,000 miles, doing dog training seminars. You can go to a couple of my websites, rvdogtrainer.com. Right now, obviously, we're in our RV and we're in Virginia. Somewhere we're in Virginia. You can actually check your map right on your Periscope, which tells you where we are. We do activate our GPS. And what you can also do is hit the little character in the corner, because then you can do a bunch of things. Follow me, so become a follower. You'll see my bio and then become a follower of mine. Turn on your alerts. Also, share this on Facebook and share this on Twitter as well. I'm exhausted, guys. Okay. So, but I'm here for you. I'm here. It's been a long, long day. Been a lot of great stuff going on. Tomorrow, there's going to be a lot of posts from the training center on Facebook. If you're not actively seeing us on Facebook, you want to make sure that we put us to the top of your queue. So there's a way that you actually can put us, so you see us all the time. Awesome. All right. So we're going to start right now. Someone said, prong cower, what's the youngest age of prong cower? All depends on the size of the dog and what's the dog doing. My opinion is I don't like to see families struggle. So if you've got a 12-week-old, 25-pound dog that's dragging you down the street, yes, there's a lot of other things you can do, but I'd like you to probably put a cower on. You would use a 2.25 millimeter prong cower. There's a specific way on how to introduce the prong cower. The prong cower is not just used, believe it or not, as an aversive. You can actually use it to whisper. You can whisper to your dog, or you can also shout to your dog. Okay? So that's what I want to do. All right? Someone else asked about fetch. No, your dog is not stupid. Fetch actually is a five-step. To do a fetch, like a forced fetch, that takes a little bit of time to do. So, for instance, a lot of dogs will fetch naturally, but literally to send a dog out, to pick it up, to bring it back, and then to drop it, that is actually multi-level protocols. So you would think that the dog would bring it back, but it doesn't. You would think the dog would go and pick it up and bring it all the way back, but it drops it halfway. So there's actually a lot of different protocols to do. So there's a lot of different ways to do it. I personally don't teach fetch, but I would go to YouTube and you can look up forced fetch, F-O-R-C-E-D, forced fetch, but also you can just train the dog to pick things up as well. Now, those are usually done with markers, so that'd be marker training. There's so many different ways you can do it, but that's not one of the things that we personally train. Hard time staying calm, muzzle conditioning because she's bitten me. Yep, that happens. Just take it slow. Just take it slow. That's all. Take it slow. So Michael Ellis has a great video on fetch on Learburg. Well, there you go. And if it's streaming, you can watch it tonight. So if you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is my website, Solid canine training, solid canine training. All right, your dog howls all day when you're away at work. My neighbors want to kill me. So what you do is get a bark collar for your dog, get a bark collar for your dog. Also, obviously you want to make sure you exercise your dog enough, but still even a tired dog will howl. What you can also do is watch my video on separation anxiety, how to prevent it and how to eliminate it. All right, and follow that all the time, all the time. So you can also get, you should be creating up your dog. How did stop your 6-month-old puppy from jumping up on your kids? Jumping, I do an aversive. Jumping, I do an aversive. So what I would do is usually dogs that jump are conditioned to jump. They've been reinforced for jumping. So they've done it even just petting the dog. You can do it. No, there's not. No, e-collar doesn't affect anything. All right. Yep, extra sensitive collar. But it all depends if it's howling or barking.
I have another question.
All right. What? Go ahead.
Reactive pit attacks crate with a dog in it that's next to him.
Okay. So what I want you to do is jumping in puppy socialization class, dressage whip on the ass. Boom. All right. So you can do a crate divider for now. Do a crate divider for now. If the dogs do not get along in the crate next to each other, get a crate divider, meaning just a piece of wood. they make privacy panels too. If you're a dog trainer in a dog training facility, they make a privacy panel. But that's not going to be good. You don't want that. All right. Yeah, the mountains here are beautiful. We passed Harper's Ferry, which I believe is where the Appalachian Trail's headquarters is. So it's right down in Harper's Ferry. Beautiful. Beautiful. We went through a new state, West Virginia. We've never been in West Virginia before. So Alicia asks on Webinar Jam, my 5-month-old German Shepherd, Belgian Malinois, has no problem with kids, but is fearful of adults. She barks and growls at them. How do I get her to stop? She has a prong collar. Well, you don't want to correct. What you want to do is, Alicia, at the moment, so your dog's possibly going through a fear stage. I would get a lot of people right now to ignore your dog. So don't have I would not put multiples in one crate, because you never know. We do with our chihuahuas, but I'd be very cautious about that. So Alicia, you're not gonna just correct it. What I would do is I would just start teaching your dog what you want. So right now I would advocate for your dog to stay calm. Get your dog to stay calm around adults. Do not allow adults to rush it. Reward the calmness. So reward the calmness. You don't want to just correct when the dog is out of control. You want to reward the calmness. So you can use the word yes. You can use the word good. You can, and you can reinforce it with food if you want to. You can do physical touch if you want to. But don't allow people to rush up to the dog. You know, oh my God, I love puppies. It's probably too much pressure on the dog. So if I came over your house, what I would possibly do is I would just walk in. I would ignore the dog, and all of a sudden the dog would go, oh, I guess you're important. So stop having people pay attention to your dog. That's what I would do for starters. All right, good.
Dog knocks owner down on walk to chase squirrel.
So the dog, so that's obviously a major problem. You actually can end up with massive amounts of issues. What I would do is I would make sure you're teaching your dog how to do a remote collar heel. Okay. Remote collar heel. I would do that on a remote collar heel. Teach the dog how to heel properly on a remote collar. That's what I would do. Also, you can use a prong collar as well. And I would also start getting that dog, what are you walking the dog on? First of all, what kind of equipment are you walking your dog on? Somebody just said a 5-month-old dog walking in adults for a male is typical. You know, a lot of 5-month-old dogs, bark at people. Somebody asked about off-leash dogs coming at you. Off-leash dogs coming at you, anything you can. Anything. So you can use a pet convincer, you can use bear spray, you can use mace, you can use pepper spray, you can use a walking stick, you can use a golf club, you can shout at the dog, you put your dog behind you, you can stick your foot out. Any dog that rushes me off leash when I'm with my dogs or my kids, it's not a good thing. Prong collar, my puppy bites leash and stops, pulls back. Is this a normal reaction to the prong? It all depends on how you condition the prong. I'm not sure if I'm understanding the whole thing, that chain that you just put in. The chain. Well, as far as for the squirrels are concerned, you're waiting too late. So you're waiting too late to give that dog information. Squirrels come out to you all of a sudden, though. I would do a crittering protocol, but what I would also do is remote collar train that dog. Go after a squirrel, I make it uncomfortable. It's as simple as that. Go after a squirrel. See, everything's good until it's good. Everything is good. So if the dog doesn't like the prong, well, what do you mean the dog doesn't like it? If the prong is harming the dog, that's a different story. But it all depends on how it's being used. It's could be just an objection as well. It could be just snotty behavior. A lot of dogs will do that. A lot of dogs will bite at a slip lead. A lot of dogs will bite at a martingale. They just don't like the fact that you're actually having them go somewhere where they didn't want to go. So it all depends on what the dog is doing. Some dogs do it literally. The most of the time we see that is the dog is objecting, meaning the dog used to pull, right? They used to pull all the time, right? Used to always pull. The owner used to always follow. Now you're not letting the dog do it, and the dog says, really? Well, I'm going to show you that I can do it. And it uses its mouth. So, what are we talking about? Well, if you just got in, I can't repeat everything. It's a Q&A dog training show. I'm not a fan on the gentle leader at all. It's a Q&A dog training show. You can go to my website, solidcaninetraining.com, solidcaninetraining.com, all right? And you can learn more about what I do. But every Monday and Wednesday night, I do a webinar. She'll charge a dog who's running in front of our house. She's a chuckle lab. She's not protecting you at all. Joggers are not trying to harm you. So your dog is not protecting you. Your dog is actually displaying really bad behavior. So if I was a jogger and your dog was running towards me, I would neutralize your dog. Sorry. I don't trust your dog. Your dog's not protecting you. So your dog, expand. I don't like gentle leaders. I'm not a big fan of them. Your dog's not protecting you. Do not allow, if your dog is off leash in your front yard and it's doing that behavior, will I kill the dog? No, I won't kill the dog. I'll kick the dog. I'll absolutely kick the dog. What do we do? You should, first of all, keep that dog on a leash at all times, and also remote collar train that dog. All right? So that's what I would do. When my dog is growling at my other dogs or cats, I try to correct her, makes her worse. Why? So obviously, Stu, you don't understand the situation. So I'll take a little time on this one right now because you did that in all caps, which means you're yelling at me. And it seems like it's your first time here. And I'm really happy that you're here, but I've been on the radio for 7 years. I've trained 3,000 dogs. I'm not going to give you my laundry list of credentials. But if a dog is running at me, chasing me, I will absolutely stop the dog. If you want to get bit by that dog, that's your choice. Okay? That's your choice. But sorry, I'm old school. I protect myself. I protect my wife. I protect my family. I protect my own dogs. If an off-leash dog comes running at me, I will stop that dog. Okay? Sorry. Dogs are killed every day for biting people. It could have all been eliminated. All right. Okay. That's a given. It's a given. So thank you. All right. What else do we got?
12-year-old Doxy is sweet, but barks until acknowledged by guests when they come over to the house.
Okay. So what's happening is the dachshund is barking until it acknowledges it. So what you've done is you've actually trained the dog to bark. So you've trained the dog to bark. Bark, bark, bark. physical touch or reward, eye contact or verbal praise until you give it something. Okay. You give it something. All right. You give it something. So what I would do is I would stop that, correct the dog, and then it's calm. So reward it for being calm. Don't reward it for barking. So I know the dog shuts up when you give it attention. All right. So what I would do is I would reverse it. Stop the dog. Keep the dog on a leash. Tell it no. Tell it quiet. All right. And then you can reward it if you want to. Then you reward it. But I want the dog to be calm when people come over. I actually want the dogs to like pretty much ignore people. That's the problem, is that people come over the house. If people come over the house, then what happens is people pay attention to little dogs. People attention to little dogs. All right. So if you've just, it seems like we have people here and I've been a little bit combative. But also, I don't think some of the questions people understand that a dog could die in a couple of ways if it bites. So if you bite my kid, it dies. Also, if you bite somebody, the city or the town will kill the dog. Just the way it is. Dogs die. So I rehabilitate aggression. So dogs die all the time. Dogs are given away. Dogs are dumped in shelters for biting. Dogs are dumped in shelters for jumping. Can you go over the proper way to train the down position? You can do it a couple of different ways. You can do it with leash pressure. You can pair it with leash pressure and food. I normally do it with leash pressure. I've got a video on how to do it on my YouTube channel. If you take the leash, we use prong cowers. So take the leash, gently step on the leash, guide the dog into a down. You can do it from a stand and you can do it from a sit. If you want to use a food lure at the same time, but we like the leash pressure as well. And we don't name it until the dog does it. So that's important that you do that. So don't give it a name until the dog does. So don't say down if the dog doesn't know down, because it doesn't know down. So get the dog to do it by either luring it or showing it. All right. And then you'll understand. Oh my gosh, that's great, Dawn. That's great. Why what, Yoda? Why? What do you do when a dog charges like it wants to kill you and your dog? I would take it seriously and I would neutralize it. But you have to remember, usually just kicking a dog is enough. Now use the word, because the dog doesn't understand. So the dog doesn't understand what it means yet. So you can't down, and then the dog won't do it. All right. So you don't have to say down. Julie, you don't have to defend me. Julie, it's okay. Julie, don't defend me. Thank you so much. I love you. Nobody ever has to defend me. Ever. Okay. Do I recommend hand signals and words when training? We use words. If you want to use hand signals and words, then. But a lot of dogs are at you when you give them a hand signal sometimes. Who's your 10-month-old pit bull biting? Who's it biting? And is it intent to harm, or is it just random nipping? Because you can't have a dog that bites. So, yeah. But if you want to do hand signals, do hand signals. We do hand signals with deaf dogs. Yeah. But you give out a lot of other signals anyway, even without your hands. You give a lot of signals out with your eyes, with your body, with your intent. So a lot of people give out signals to their dogs anyway, with their energy. Small dog who puts mostly playful. Okay. Mostly playful. Let me address that. First of all, mostly playful is just stop it. Just correct it. Get a pet convincer. Just a pet convincer is just air. Just a pet convincer is air. Just goes to play, bite you, air. Some people use spray bottles. We don't, but if it works, go ahead. I just don't use them. But a pet convincer is air. Just use air. All it does is, spray air at the dog. Dog goes to bite, spray. But also, make sure you can turn that dog on and turn it off. Meaning, so what I want you to do is playful mouth. Should I correct? Yeah. Yep. But you can also start teaching it controlled biting. You can teach it tug. Okay. So you can teach it tug. So teach it to bite and then not bite. But only use one thing. That's it.
I've got a ton of questions here.
You know, kicking them works the best. So remember, people, no, just let me just address this one more time too, also, because obviously it's on my mind and I'm neurotic, if you can't tell. So I'm not saying walk up to dogs and kick them. I'm not saying walk up to dogs and kill them. I'm not saying walk up to dogs and harm them. But I don't go around the streets hitting people. But if you come near me and touch me, I defend myself. And if you touch my wife and touch my kids, it's over. End of story. We should all be more like that, right? Right? Let's all move to Texas. What's the question?
Tons of questions. What are your thoughts on clickers?
I have no problem with clickers at all. So just so you know, Yoda, you obviously are talking about the seminar we did on Saturday with Stick. You know, we've always used markers. We've always used markers in our training. All a clicker is a marker. The great thing that I learned about clickers was obviously the timing is much better. The timing is much better. The timing is much better. So that's the great that. So, and also you can give the dog a more clear, defined way of when they did something correct. So that's the magic of that. So I love the seminar. I loved it. We're going to incorporate that into our board and train program, but not with clients. But we're going to probably incorporate that in some of our protocols for the board and train dogs. Yep. Yeah, we're going to play around with it. See what it works for. See what it works for. So for some counter conditioning protocols, we'll see what it works for. Yep. We're experimenting with it. You know. So, yeah. Guys, you have to remember, I'm open to a lot of stuff. I'm open to a lot of stuff. I was originally turned off. I mean, everybody knows my story. You know, the biggest amount of hate mail that I get are from clicker trainers and from positive reinforcement trainers. So I've sort of been tainted. I've been tainted, you know. Also, I just found out, and I'm finding out, that most people that use clickers in food are doing it wrong. So even people that say they do it wrong. No, T3 does not do clickers. Nope. No, T3 does not do clickers. No. So there's plenty of people that do clickers. You know, so that's the thing. So that's the thing. But again, anything positive, so clickers fall into the, anything positive reinforces a wanted behavior. Just keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. Okay. So when a dog is biting you, you know, what are they doing wrong? Their timing is wrong. Their timing is wrong. Their timing is wrong, and they actually don't understand the concept of, you know, yes and no. Food is a bribe is wrong, right? So what we were doing actually is we had our hand in the food bag, even with marker training, we had our hand in the food bag, which is wrong. So don't have your hand in the food bag and then just reward the dog. That's right. Also, variable rewards I learned about. So I learned about variable rewards, and I learned about not keeping your hand in the food bag. I learned about that. So I learned a lot. I learned a lot. It was great. One more tool in the toolbox to keep helping dog. To help keep helping dogs. All right. So, Southern California, I'll be out in San Diego and Los Angeles in a couple of weeks. We just had somebody come into our training center to do private training with our staff. We had a one-day clicker demo, clicker training. And a lot of it was more than half of it was on theory, which was very helpful as well. I mean, none of that stuff gets repeated to clients or anything like that, but it was just important to know. It helped reaffirm that a lot of different things, that we're on the right path, but we obviously always have stuff to learn. So always have stuff to learn. I never claim to know everything. That's why I personally go to seminars, and that's why I bring seminar people in. And that's why I'm constantly learning. So it's funny. A lot of people are like, where did you go to school for dog training? I didn't. I've trained 3,000 dogs. I learn as I go. The cool thing is I never stop learning. So that 80% of college graduates never pick up a book. 80% of college graduates never pick up a book. I listen to audiobooks all day long. How to help an obsessed dog to focus on the ball and retrieving, teach it to out the ball and go to place. Out the ball and go to place. Yeah, Texas canine. I learn something from every single person I come in contact. Every single person I come in contact. So hold on a little bit of station break. There's a little character in the corner there. Click on that. You can start following me. Go to my bio and follow me. Also, share me on Twitter. Share me on Facebook. Share me on Periscope. Go to my website, solidcaninetraining.com. Solidcaninetraining.com. Also, who's in the house here? Clover, Romy. Say hello. Show your face. Angelo. Hey, buddy.
Hey.
Hey. And then I've got Uma and Girl. You can also give me Mad Hearts. Yeah, there's tons of things to learn. The bottom line is if you can take, you know, if you can take one or two things from every person you do, then you're awesome. You're awesome. See, that's the difference. That's the difference between, you know, our company and other people, is especially the positive camp. You know, I don't think my way is the only way. You know, I don't think my way is the only way. But the cool thing is, I only give out advice on things that we've done successfully. That's the cool thing. If I don't know how to do something, I'll be the first one to say, I don't know how to do it. I've never done it. I don't know. So you've got an anxious dog. Watch my video. So watch my video. All right. So watch my video on separation anxiety. Follow it 100%. 100% follow it. Yeah. And what works for us doesn't work for somebody else. And what works for somebody else doesn't work for us. There's so many variables. Guys, they're dogs. They're dogs. There's so many variables. We're trying to find something always. We're trying to find something always that, you know, works and can improve on us. I work on myself every day. I work on my team of staff every day. I work on my relationship with my wife and my kids every day. I work on my skills every day. I work on my mind every day. So what else?
Is it important for a dog to look in your eyes when you give a command?
Is it important to let your to look in your dog? Is it important for your dog to look in your eyes? Not necessarily. Not necessarily. They should be focused on you at some point, but not necessarily. Sometimes you want to pick your battles, right? Pick your battles. But you can reward with eye contact. So if your dog is dog crazy, I'll tell you what, tomorrow's Periscope, I'll do a demo with Girl on how I want eye focus so she gets a reward. All right? I'll do that. How's that? So it helps. Focus helps. Focus helps. What else?
How do you train an old dog?
How do you train an old dog? As long as the dog is breathing, the same as you would a over 1 year old dog. Find out what motivates it and train it. So it's all based on motivation. What motivates it? What motivates it? What motivates the dog? Food, play, right? Cramping finger. Are you doing this or are you doing this? Ladies, you'll understand what that means. Okay? Okay. So, motivation. Same way, though. Same way. I actually find that having a raised place platform is much better. Much better. It gives them a very defined area to go to. A very defined area to go to. All right? So, all right. What else we got?
How do you control a dog when it wants to run after other dogs?
How do you control a dog when it wants to? There's a couple different ways you can do. Put the dog into aversion, which would be a high level stim. You can also teach the dog impulse control. So teach the dog a down, place, or heel, and then don't allow it to go after other dogs. So that's impulse control. But first, you want to go to obedience. But you can do obedience, but then you also have to modify the dog's behavior of lunging at other dogs. Raised platform beds, I get mine from Petcot, and also Climb, K-L-I-M-B. I'll do something tomorrow morning on Climb. I'll do a dog training demo tomorrow with one of my dogs, all right? But going after other dogs, knucklehead has a recall, yep. That's how that will be after the fact. Knucklehead, good point. You know, good point. What about dog fights? What about dog fights?
I did have a question here. How do you break up a dog fight?
You prevent a dog fight. You prevent the dog fight. So once the dogs are fighting, depends on if they're just making a lot of noise or if they actually have got a grip on the other dog. If they've got a grip on the other dog. So if they've got a grip on the other dog, you walk up to the dog that has a grip on the other dog and you give them a very, very hard kick right at the sweet spot. Yes, I'm encouraging you to kick a dog again, right in the sweet spot between the back legs and the rib cage. The back legs and the rib cage. You do everything possible, but without using your hands in there. I'd rather use your feet. Now, you can pick up the back legs and pull the dog back like a wheelbarrow. But if the dog is clamped on, you know, you can, but fire extinguisher works well. If you have one, yep. 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 I mean, there's a lot of different ways. Water on the dog, but it all depends on the intensity of the fight. Some dogs that fight that want to kill, you have to choke the dog out. You got to choke the dog out. So there's a lot of ways. Yeah, underneath, yeah, sort of underneath to the side. Yep, really soft spot. Very, very soft spot. You'll cause the dog will be in pain. And some people will struggle with that concept too. What does it mean when the dog has hackles up? What do you do when your dog's hackles it's up? It means it's excited. Means it's excited. It's just a sense of excitement. It doesn't always mean that it's going to be aggressive. It just means it's excited. So when my dogs go to the ocean or they go out to the swimming pool, their hackles go up. They're excited. All right. What else?
Small dog puts brakes on the treadmill.
Small dog, yeah, putting brakes on the treadmill. What I would do is condition the dog better to the treadmill. What you can do is you want to get at least one set of steps. So you want to get like all four paws to move, and then you would mark that, and you reward it. So start it at 1 mile per hour. 1 mile per hour. You can also do a little bit of leash pressure. But if the dog is dragging, like literally dragging, you know. You want to do a little bit of leash pressure. He won't eat. He's got to be motivated. Don't feed him any other time until you don't feed the dog any other time until you want to do this protocol. So yeah, dragging. So I would do this. Is the dog afraid of the treadmill? Is the dog totally afraid of the, will the dog go on the treadmill when it's off? Will go on its treadmill when it's off. So there's four different people that have got decent videos out there. Tyler Muto, Blake Rodriguez, myself, Jeff Gellman, and then also Sean O'Shea. We all have four different videos, and then probably Tori Smith has some videos as well. All right. Write that question down. Robin will get right to you. Okay.
I already did.
Oh, he eats when it's not running. Now we can only eat when it is running. All right. We've got a lot of our dogs at our house. We have somebody staying at we have a whole family staying at our house. There's a whole family staying at our house, taking care of a bunch of our dogs and our cat and the house. Oh, what to say when people tell them no. So lady, if that was Lady Jane, tell them no. No, you can't. No. So I don't let people pet any of my dogs. No, you can't pet my dogs. Cool. I'm not familiar with Kooloo, but if they're raised up, I like them, right? So just tell people they're not allowed to pet your dog. No, you can't pet my dog. So a lot of people don't even ask. What else?
Is it okay to let your dog on the couch, but only when you
say? Yeah, it's okay to let your dog on the couch when you say. Yep, definitely. What if it's a cute girl? If it's a cute girl, I still don't let them pet my dogs. Yep, I still don't let them pet my dogs. So, because if that's all you care about is my dogs, I probably don't, you know. So that's not what I want. I don't let anybody pet my dogs. Other than at the training center during like a training protocol. Somebody asked about how to introduce your dog to a fearful dog. A fearful dog is to people, that's aggressive towards people, get them to exist around people. Get them to exist around people. Existence is the first thing. Don't go to dog parks. West Virginia girl, if that's what that stands for, never be going to dog parks. Okay. So don't go to dog parks. Dog parks are not good to go to. You'll never see me at a dog park. You'll never see a lot of good dog trainers there. Yes, you do. Trainer to be off leash, and you can find lots of places, plenty of places. So keep if your dog's not off leash trained, keep a long line on it. Why don't I like dog parks? I'll tell you why I don't like dog parks. Number one, most dogs learn bad behaviors there. You don't know the health history or the behavior of any of the dogs there. Most people that bring their dogs there do not have any behavior. They don't even understand their own dog. They allow bad behaviors. Okay, they allow bad behaviors on their dog that actually can start a dog fight or make your dog afraid. Dogs put way too much pressure on other dogs. And the bottom line is, I can't correct any of the dogs. And if a dog is doing something, one of my dogs, that I don't want it to, there's no benefit of a dog park. Yep, baseball diamonds, tennis courts, soccer fields. There's plenty of places to take your dog running. Long walk. Go find an open field. An e-cow or stim, an electrical shock can kill you. It's as simple as that. An electrical shock can kill you. An e-cow or stim cannot. So, all right. I would let my children feel an e-cow or stim, but I would never let them feel an electrical shock. I would never electrically shock my dogs. I would never electrically shock anybody's dog. So the technical part about it, e-collar technologies, e-collar.com has the technical part, and I believe it's amps, amperage. There's not enough amperage. So I put remote collars on my neck, I turn them all the way up. So you're not gonna see me sticking my finger in an electrical outlet. So it's a big difference. It's not electricity. Electricity is the thing that goes in those power lines that's powering lights. Remote collars don't do that. You also can do this. You take a remote collar in your hand, put and say you can feel it at 20, put it in water. Now you got to put it up to 30 or even 40, right? Take a curling iron, put it in the bathtub. You die. All right? You die. Helping a dog get used to the noises of city life, get a download sounds from YouTube. Download sounds from YouTube, all different sounds, taxi cabs, horns, traffic, sewer noises, bicycles. Your dog hates small children, tries to bite them. Keep them away from small children right now.
It says she went on vacation and left her schnauzer with friends with kids. Now the dog hates kids.
Yeah, probably because the kids put way too much pressure. So obviously you're not going to do that again, right? You're not going to do that again. What everyone can do is also, if you like this, cots of hearts, give me lots of hearts. All right? So give me lots of hearts also. There's a little character in the corner. Hit that. You can hit that, and you can share me on Facebook, share me on Twitter, share me on Periscope. Also, make sure you're a follow me. Go into my bio and follow me, and then also turn on your alert. A 3-month-old puppy for calmness, just crate time. A 12-week-old puppy should probably be in the crate 20 hours a day. Best place for the dog while you're sleeping is the crate. Is the crate. The best, safest place for your dog is a crate. Take your dog, Bill, take your dog to one spot on a leash and reward it. So one spot on a, you know, so take your dog out to, take your dog out at the beginning. Leash on the dog, go out the same door, go to the same spot where you want your dog to go. It goes potty, reward it. You can say good. You can use food. Use its daily food if you want to. You can reward it. We learned this weekend if you want to click it. So it's got expected thing. Do I eat collar correct for growling? Do we eat collar correct for growling? Yes, we do. But it all depends on what the intent is. What is the intent? What's the intent? So if my dog is chewing a toy and another dog came up to it, another dog came up to it to take the toy, and my dog goes, I wouldn't correct my dog. Brian Costa, he's one of my Periscope fans. He had his 15-week-old puppy in for training and with Uma, and the dog kept being a pain in the butt. Being a pain in the butt around Uma. Uma growled. The dog didn't back up. Uma growled louder. The dog didn't back up. So I used the dressage whip. I spanked the dog on the ass.
You see, it just growls when...
Check your dog for medical. Check your dog for medical. Make sure there's nothing wrong with your dog, first of all, medically. Also, is your dog standing up? Is your dog lying down? You should never leave any collar on in the crate. Not even the flat buckle collar. But we're a training facility. Sometimes we have to leave collars on the crate. Sometimes we leave muzzles on the crate. So, because we're a dog training facility. Transition to fully off leash in the house for older pups. If you're remote collar training the dog, make sure that you've gone to correction mode. Proof it. Proof the dog. Run them through commands. Gradually add liberties. Gradually add freedom. Gradually add freedom. So, growling for a scary sound, I wouldn't. Nope, I wouldn't. I would desensitize that dog to the sound. So that's like if you went to a, not a choking hazard, but it can get caught on the side. It can get caught on the side of the crate. What about when your six-month-old puppy growls at you? I would correct that. Yeah, there's always exceptions. So bark collars are on in the crate because the dog barks. Right. Yep. Yeah, dogs shouldn't be growling at you. Oh, no, your dog's just not socialized. Yes, I crate my dogs. Yes. Your dog's just not well socialized. So it needs to be around other dogs, but it needs to be in a structured socialization group. So in other words, there's a specific way how we socialize dogs. This is very specific way. This weekend seminar in, Mr. Rowe, this weekend seminar in Austin, Texas, I'll do a demo on that. And I've got videos that demonstrate it on my YouTube channel and on my Facebook page, how we introduce dogs. I actually wouldn't allow dogs to, thanks, Knucklehead.
Thank you.
Thanks. So Knucklehead's leaving. Someone's got to make up for all the hearts that Knucklehead gave. All right. So, what I do is we keep dogs away from that dog. We teach that dog how to exist around dogs. Because even a friendly dog coming up to your unsocial dog will still freak it out. Will still freak it out. No, beagle puppies aren't hard to train. Do I come to New York City? I used to come to New York City all the time, but not really much that much. But I've got a lot of clients from New York City that come to me. They come to me. Do I ever do seminars in Chicago? Not yet, but as soon as I find a location, I will. I will. If you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Solid Canine Training. All right? Go to my website, learn more about me. All right? How do you train yourself not to become anxious when we are approached by other dogs? Well, it depends if it's a... an off-leash dog or an on-leash dog. So if your dog is fearful of the roommate's friends, don't let your dog bark. Don't let your dog bark. If you're in Austin, Mr. Rogue, I'll be in Austin. Go to my seminar this weekend. Go to my seminar this weekend. Go to rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com. It's actually in Lexington. But I'm available for privates. What location would I be looking for in Chicago? We need a dog training facility that has hosted seminars before, so they understand the concept. We need to be able to hold 15 dogs, 30 to 35 people. Parking should be very, very easy. All right. That's what I'm looking for. You would email my assistant, Lauren, L-A-U-R-E-N, Lauren at Solid Canine Training. Dog to be reactive to cats on your walks, I would put the dog into avoidance. I would just correct high for that. I don't sing. I danced this morning though, Brett. I danced this morning. Go to my Facebook page. You can see me dancing this morning in the RV. Don't sing. I don't even do happy birthday. Training two beagle pups together. They fight. First train them by themselves. Lauren, L-A-U, Lauren, like Lauren Bacall, L-A-U-R-E-N, at the name of my company, solidcaninetraining.com. I won't do wheels on the bike. I'll tell you what, stick around to the end of Periscope, and I'll get my son to sing, all right?
You don't want Jeff singing.
Okay, I'll get my son to sing.
Just saying.
All right? Okay. Lauren, thank you, Julie. Lauren. All right? Two beagles that are fighting, first you gotta train them by themselves. You're gonna be disappointed then, Brett. You're gonna be disappointed, man. Mm-hmm. Sorry to let you down. Let me try to stay on focus though, okay? Stay on focus. I gotta stay on focus, all right? Two beagles that are fighting together, first train them by themselves. Then you gotta stop them from fighting. We got a lot of different protocols on how to stop from fighting. Okay? So Periscope is not usually a how to stop a dog from fighting platform. All right. How to get your dog to stop barking at other dogs. Correct it. So prong collar, remote collar. Say, no, correct. How do I deal with off-leash dogs on the walks? We talked that for like the first 15 minutes. Watch the replay. I do whatever I can to stop that dog. All right.
I have a lot of questions.
Okay, go ahead.
What dog training literature do you recommend?
Dog training literature do I recommend? I think everybody should find a good book on, like, how to raise a good puppy. Get some technical books on animal behavior if you want. Get some books on how to understand motivation in dogs. The Keeler book is, you don't have to scream at me. You don't have to do all caps. I'll think you're screaming at me. And I don't want you to scream. You can ask me nicely. I'll get you. It's okay. I know you're excited. Do I have a video on pack dynamics? Not really. I just do socialization sessions all the time. Sarah, I love you. Thank you. Thank you, Sarah. I love you. So not on pack dynamics. It worked for you, so I guess it's okay. But I'd be really super cautious about that. I wouldn't encourage it. But if it worked for you, we'll leave it at that. How's that? All right? I won't tell anybody. Next question.
How do I find a full-time dog nanny?
Full-time dog nanny? Do you mean you want to find a pull? There probably is no best training behavior books. Read them all. Read them all, Lady Jane. Read them all. I don't know. Read them all. I would put something out. I would go to talk to the vet. Talk to the vet. Vet assistants get paid shit money. They probably love to take care of your dog. Okay? You try to love to take care of your dog. That's what I would do. All right. Put an ad out in the paper, Craigslist. Just be careful. Yep, Keeler's great. Bill Keeler's book is great. Just get a basic Keeler book. Bill Keeler.
Somebody asked us what was for supper tonight.
What was for supper tonight? We didn't have supper. We had dinner. When we go to Texas, we'll be having supper and dinner. So what we had was a stir fry of shrimp and vegetables and tater tots because they didn't have a starch. I forgot to pick up rice, so I made tater tots. And we had some cheese and crackers to start. And Linda has some red wine.
For the hot.
Best toy dog for boredom. I don't use the toy dogs from boredom. I don't use toys for boredom. We just keep dogs busy, right? We keep dogs busy. Keep dogs busy. So then when they rest, they just rest. They just rest. Does that make sense? So we use toys for play.
What? Ew, vegetables?
Oh, get off.
What the heck?
Kathy, come on now.
Shaking my head.
Thank you, polite pause. See, that you like my dance. A lot of people like my dance. A lot of people like my dance.
I just wasn't ready for it yet.
Okay. You got to remember, I was up for 3 hours. I was up already for 3 hours. Okay, I was outside. I already worked my dogs. Someone's awake. Yeah, that was girl that just popped up. What else?
I put a baby gate up, set up in the corner of my bedroom to put the dog in. Is that okay?
I would rather use a crate. I would rather you use a crate than a baby gate in the corner. But I mean, if it works for you, works for you. I'm just a big advocate of containment. I'm just a big advocate of crating dogs. And yes, I crate all my own dogs. In the RV, I don't. My dogs, sorry, webinar jam, you can't see this really, but my dogs are here at night. What are the best accommodations for dogs if you do have to go out of town? I would find a pet sitter to come to your house. Or build a relationship. Build a relationship with a boarding train facility or a boarding facility. Start building a relationship with one. Talk to your vet, maybe one of the vet techs that you really like. I used to hike with three dogs. I'm sorry, two dogs, Uma and Max. I used to backpack with Uma and Max all the time. It's a great thing to do. Appalachian Trail, Long Trail. We used to go on 1 week excursions with my dogs. Big German Shepherds. Yep. Taking your dogs in the woods is a very primal thing. It's fantastic. They love it. They love it. Just make sure you know dog first aid. Do you use the holistic health for your pups? I don't, but what is it? I'm not against it. I don't know what it is. Holistic health, is that an additive or is that a form of medicine? Why does my dog bark a little? It's just because that's what dogs do. Dogs do. Oh, essential oils? I don't. I'm not against it, though. I'm not against it at all. How to stop your dog from rushing the picture window? You can put him into avoidance if you want. Correct it. Rush the picture window? That sucked. I don't put boots on my dogs. Nope. I don't put my boots on my dogs. For hiking, depends where. So we did a lot of backpacking in New England where the trails are really narrow. And we've got a lot of foliage. So I like them to
you
not.
You did not say that.
Foliage?
Foliage, honey. Oh my God.
Foliage?
It's foliage.
What did I say?
Foliage is what I say when I'm making fun of people.
Oh.
Foliage.
Foliage.
Oh my God.
We got a lot of shrubs and trees and
crap like that.
And bushes and crap like that. All right.
So, my mind is officially friggin' blown.
All right.
I don't even know if I can continue.
So we've got a lot of stuff like that. So usually not more than 15 feet.
Sorry.
I feed raw to some of my dogs. He wants to watch and correct. You've got a herding dog. You've got a herding dog. Then don't let him. Don't let him. See, older bird, two wise men in the room.
Well, I'm laughing at both of
okay,
you now.
Okay, two wise men, older bird, right? Two wise men in the room. Come on, two wise men in the room. All right, so yes, your dog can have multiple places. Yes. Yeah, she, yeah, of course. How to correct herding, remote collar or dressage whip. But also give the dog a herding job somewhere else though. Get, let it herd something else. They make those balls. They make that herding ball. All right. What else do we got, Linda?
Puppy is calm during training. Then the kids come into the room and it's blown.
Puppy is calm towards training. The kids are a humongous distraction. Humongous distraction. So you have to, kids should learn to come in the room calmly. Kids should come into the room calmly instead of coming in the room out of control. But remember, anytime you add a new distraction, it's more difficult for the dog. So the kids are probably the highest distraction that there is. So your kids are probably the highest distraction that you've got. Highest distraction. So you got to work your dog through that. Work your dog through it. Your dog is so nervous of anything and anything, trees, cars, people, everything. Why? Probably lack of socialization. Lack of socialization, and you might be reinforcing it, not on purpose, but without knowing it. So for instance, when your dog is being nervous, what do? Say a car goes by, your dog is nervous, what do? What else?
You're asking me?
How many e-collar sessions before introducing distractions? Wait till the dog understands the basic command. You hug her? Are you being serious? That's the wrong thing to do. That means you're training your dog to be, you're training your dog to be nervous. Go ahead.
Will you be in Ohio in 2016?
Will I be in Ohio in 2016? Most likely. Most likely.
Do you carry pepper spray when you're walking?
No, I don't. Your dog tries to eat flies. Flies are nutritious. Don't worry. Good protein. No, I don't carry pepper spray at all. I've got my feet. Sometimes I've got a pet convincer, and I'm really good at stopping dogs. So, all right. Don't reinforce. So you've got a fearful dog. Your fearful, anxious dog. Ignore it. Pretty much ignore it right now. Yeah. You're not comforting her. So you're not comforting her. You're training her to be nervous. You just gave her the biggest reinforcer in the world. You gave her the biggest reinforcer in the world. Your dog did something and you told it how good it was. Think about that. Think about that. So your dog did something and you told it was correct. So just think about that. If your dog sat and you would tell it good, you teach it to sit. Your dog exhibits fear, you tell it it's good, the dog learns to be fearful. I'm a huge advocate of spay and neuter, yes. But I'm also a big advocate of freedom of choice with women and your dog, your personal dog. Do I believe that shelter dogs should all be spayed and neutered before they get adopted out? Yes, I do.
What's the women thing?
Your freedom of choice.
Oh.
Yeah, the confidence work is a whole different thing. So do you talk to your dog? Is it weird? No. So, you know, this is the thing is there's so many ways to get rid of nervousness and fear. And that's a lot of that's through is a lot of that is through massive amounts of confidence building, tons of structure, lots of guidance. Right now, micromanaging things, teach your dog obedience, right? Teach your dog obedience. And then also what I would do. Yes. All my dogs are spayed and neutered. Yep. All my dogs are spayed and neutered. Yep. That's the way I got them. Highly structured lifestyle. Yep. Highly structured. Everything should be structured. Crate your dog. Don't reinforce it. Don't reinforce it. That's probably what you're doing. So if you're hugging your dog, this probably goes on to a lot of other things. Thank you, Mishkos. How are you? Probably goes on to a lot of other things. So if you're just tuning in, we're almost over. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Go to my website. All right. And you can also click. Good, we're back. Oh, thanks, Joe Rat. Yeah, this is just my Q&A. Yeah, I turned it on airplane mode, but I'm on a mini iPad here. I'm on a mini iPad. I'm on a mini iPad. Do I see big difference in neutered, non-neutered? Only with Mark? No, I don't. I don't. I don't. Every aggressive dog that's ever come into me has been fixed. Most dogs that come into me are fixed. And they've got every aggression problem under the sun. Do I use conditioner for my hair? Yes, I do. All right, guys. We're done answering questions because Linda's going to go. The brand, what's that brand that I use? It's from Australia.
Aussie.
Aussie. 3 minute.
But you don't leave it in for 3 minutes.
But I don't leave it in for 3 minutes.
I gotta go.
Oh, then it's gonna go. Yeah, she's got purple hair.
Mm-hmm. I do.
We will. We will. Hold on. Hold on, guys. We're not done yet. Linda's done.